According to the CDC, about 1 in every 54 kids has autism. This research was done in the US, and I would assume the figures don't change that much across the globe. Since autism is quite widespread, I'm sure we've run into many autistic people in our lives, whether it be at school, university, or at work. And even though it's so widespread, there aren't many actually autistic anime characters that I can name off from the top of my head. Yet there is one which stands as the clear, easy pick when it comes to naming autistic characters. The man, the myth, the legend, Nezuma Eiji. Whilst it's not stated outright that the character is autistic, it's quite clearly shown by the range of his behaviours. I've come across many people speculating that Nezuma has Asperger's syndrome, which in a diagnostic sense, as of today, has no real difference between autism spectrum disorder. And just to make things easier for myself, I'll be referring to it as autism, as many people have outlined before. The goat himself, Nezuma, likely has autism, and some of the more relevant autistic traits which you can easily identify would include things such as extremely excelling in one area, intense passion for manga, being an absolute legend, hates crowds and is socially awkward, he sticks to a strict routine, for example always wearing the same clothes, the odd noises he makes as he draws, and doing your mum. Whilst some of these could easily be just written down as a little weird or just being an anime character thing, there's still traits that can be seen in real life. The only odd one being the doing your mum, but that's there as tradition on this channel. Otherwise, an example which is quite debatable is that he wears the same clothes almost all the time. Whilst this can be just an anime thing, we can look at the main characters of the show and see the constant changes in their outfits, and this is never seen with Nezuma, which in my books is solid enough evidence to support that particular point. And honestly, if I was Nezuma, I'd never wear anything else either. The man is just dripping. So why is the portrayal of autism so great in Bakuman? The main point is that it's used masterfully to create a fun and interesting character. Nezuma is one of my favourite characters in all of manga and anime, and him being autistic is definitely a good part of that. The many autistic traits which he possesses makes him such an incredible character to follow. The amount of interesting interactions which occur throughout the runtime of the series is quite staggering. His quirks just make for such a iconic moments. I can think of a few moments where Nezuma says something really cool, and literally a few panels later, he's just doing some dumb shit. Another reason why I think Bakuman does a great job is that they never play his autism for laughs. He's never the butt of the joke. If we're ever laughing, it's with him, and never at him. The series doesn't take the opportunity to go for dirty humour, and rather portrays autistic spectrum disorder as something positive, and welcomes Nezuma with open arms. The way his autism helps him write his stories almost reminds me of the Kanye West meme, where he says that his ADHD is a superpower and not a disability. This can be seen by the way Nezuma writes his characters in his stories. It's almost like they live in his head, and he doesn't need to think too deeply on how they act. You can see them being alive in his imagination. In a way that really reminds me of Kentaro Miura's writing and how his characters feel so alive and real. I think Nezuma's writing could have had some similarities in a way. In conclusion, Bakuman does an incredible job of portraying Nezuma's autism in a positive light and makes him such a charismatic and overall an iconic character. I do hope with time we get more characters like Nezuma, which might be a little bit more weird, but always a joy to have on the screen or on the page. Watch Bakuman, subscribe, and peace.